JJ, Mum's here. Look at Kissy.
Jonathan Riggsby can't function like a normal 20-year-old. He can't tie his shoe, write his name, or read a book because of a brain injury.
Yay. You gonna wake up?
When he was 14 months old, he and his 2-year-old sister fell into their parents' swimming pool. They had been in the care of a babysitter.
When she came out from the back of the house, she saw the children went there, the door was wide open. She went out to the backyard, they're both white floating, face down in the swimming pool.
The Consumer Product Safety Commission says one of the most important things a pool owner can do is create barriers that provide layers of protection around a pool and which allow a parent to find a missing child before they get into trouble. These include walls or fences that are at least 4 feet high and well-maintained latches that are out of reach and close automatically. Door alarms if your house forms one of the walls around the pool, because these will let a parent know if a door is unexpectedly opened. Or a power safety cover, which keeps children out and has a top that can be easily cleared of water, since a child can drown in less than 2 inches.
A lot of pool owners don't think that this is a problem because they don't have children, but it is. 35% of these accidents don't happen at the child's home, and if a child wanders into your pool and is injured, it's your liability, and it could affect you for the rest of your life.
Jonathan Riggsby survived his accident, but his 2-year-old sister did not. Most drownings occur in both residential and community pools when one or both parents are watching the child but are distracted for a few minutes.
So what'd you do today?
Nadina Riggsby now spends her time telling her story and teaching pool owners how to have safer pools. And she hopes her efforts will prevent what happened to Jonathan from happening to anyone else.
There we go.
Carolyn Gorman reporting.